welcome to the fourth lecture of the current electricity. Today's topic is color coding for the carbon resistors, right? Carbon resistors, if you see, we'll see that in the end of this lecture practically. Carbon resistors, if you see, they have a color strips on them which specify some numbers. They specify their value. Let us see exactly how they look. So, carbon resistors, if you closely notice, it is a two terminal device and there are color strips 1, 2, 3 and there are total 4 colors on them. First color represents some digit X, second color represents some digit Y and the third color represents some digit Z. And final strip, it represents some tolerance T. So ultimately, based on these digits, the value of this resistor can be written as 10 to the power Z plus or minus T. Right? Now what are these colors? Right? Color 1, color 2, color 3, color 4. So there are total 10 different colors based on the 10 different digits. What are those colors? Let us see them. It represents black color. If you find black color, then it represents a value 0. Brown 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 and 9. So these are the different colors, right? So to understand this, and the T, it represents a tolerance. Tolerance, you may have this last color T, it is either gold, silver or there can be no color. So if it is gold, it is 5% tolerance, if it is silver, it is 10% tolerance and if it is no color, it has 15% tolerance. Gold, silver and no color. Right? Now what do we mean by tolerance? Tolerance means variation in the value of the resistor. These resistors, they are not very accurate enough. This device, when they are manufactured, they had some little bit variations in their values. Those variations in their values are called as tolerance. Let us see example. So if you take a resistor, right, let us say you have three different colors. First color is green, other one is yellow, third one is white, right, and here you have gold. Then what will be the value of this resistor? Now see, exactly as per this, X is gray. Gray stands for 8, then Y, yellow stands for 4, multiplied by 10 to the power Z. Z is white, so 10 to the power 9 plus or minus gold means 5%, so 5% gold. This is the value of this resistor given. What does it mean? This means this is the value with 5% plus or minus. The value can be 5% higher or 5% lower, right? Because manufacturing this device is with a high accuracy is not at all possible. So that is the color coding of the carbon resistor. Hello friends, this is the resistor. Exactly it looks somewhat like this, right? If you see, you can find 1, 2, 3 and 4 colors on it. This is also another resistor. Again, if you notice it closely, this also have a 4 different colors on it. Right, 1, 2, 3 and 4 different colors. We can find out its value. Right, if we write down the colors, the first color is brown here. Second color seems black. So we can write down brown, black and the third color is yellow. And the fourth one is golden. So gold. So what does the brown represent? So brown is number 1. Black is number, represents the number 0 if you refer to the color coding. Right, and yellow represents 4 number. Gold represents 5% tolerance, correct? So now if we write down the values, so X, Y into 10 to the power Z, this is color X, this is Y, this is Z, right? So it will be, what will be its value? It will be 1, 0 into 10 to the power 4 plus or minus 5% ohm. So this is the value of the resistor. Let us look out at this another resistor. There is another resistor, right? So for this also you can identify the colors and find out its value for yourself.
these are the carbon resistors. There are different type of the resistors. This is called as a carbon resistor. One color, second color, third color, right? Red, red, black, and golden. You can find out its value.
Then next one we have is combination of resistors. So let us say we have some resistors which are connected in the series. Then what will be the equivalent resistor? It is very simple, right? Let us say I have three different resistors R1, R2 and R3. If they are connected in the series, right? Let D be the potential difference applied. So it is a series combination. Current will remain same throughout. Potential will be different for everyone. This is a logical thing, right? Current is flow of electrons. Electrons have a one single path to go. So as electrons flow, resistance will drop the potential as per its capacity. Then R2 will drop the potential as per its capacity, and then the R3 will drop the potential as per its capacity. So now we can write down here V is equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3, right? Applying Ohm's law, we know that V is equals to IR. Applying Ohm's law, so for V1 it will be IR1, V2 it will be IR2, and V3 it will be IR3. So taking out I common, it will be R1, R2 plus R3. So in the series combination, right, it is just the summation of the resistors, algebraic sum of the resistors. Similarly, let us see what is the resistance when they are connected in the parallel. So let us say resistance connected in parallel. So again, for our simplification, we will take three resistors connected in the parallel. R1, R2, R3, and they are connected with a potential difference of V0. Now here in parallel combination, again, as the current starts flowing from the positive terminal, current which is nothing but the flow of electrons. This flow of electrons or current, it can be just compared with the flow of water. So flow of water has now three paths to go. Similarly, current also, as it reaches this junction, it has a three path to go. I1, I2 and I3. Let I1, I2 and I3 be three different currents. So I get splitted up into I1, I2 and I3. As I said, current is just like a water flow. So water from the main pipe, when it is supplied to the different houses, so water, same amount of water can be distributed to the different houses. So summation of all the water to the different houses will give you the total quantity of the water supplied. Here you can say current. Current in the each branch, right, will be equal to the current supplied. Now here in the parallel combination, potential will remain same, right? All of them are sitting parallelly. I hope you very well understand the parallel combination. Parallel combination is just you are sitting at a round table. You can consider potential as a food. So when you sit in the round table and food in the center, everyone gets an equal amount of food. But here in series combination, you sit one after the other. Now here as the food starts distributing, right, first one will take up to its capacity, second one will take up to its capacity, but maybe the last person may not get sufficient amount of food. So same thing happens in a series combination. The bulbs connected in the series, the bulbs are connected in the series. First glow with the maximum brightness, second with a little lesser, third with a much lesser, and so on. The last bulb, right, it may get a very very less potential. So the last bulb may seem glowing dim. Whereas in the parallel combination, all the three bulbs, they get equal amount of potential. So their brightness are same, but the current is different. But even though current is different, all the three bulbs will be seen glowing with an equal brightness. Here, this will be higher brightness, lesser brightness and the least brightness. Let us find out the equation of the resistance in parallel. So if we simplify this one and applying the Ohm's law, right, I will be equal to V by R. So V by R1 for first resistance, if we apply the Ohm's law here, it will be V by R1, right? For second resistance, it will be V by R2 and V by R3. If your basics about resistors, potential, current, all these terms are weak, then you should go to the lectures of 10th standard physics. There you can very well understand what do you mean by resistor, what do you mean by potential, what do you mean by current. These are all lower class derivations. So in parallel combinations, we obtain equivalent resistance as per this. You can write down in summation format that resistance in parallel combination is summation of 1 upon Ri, where I is equals to 1 and I belongs to mutual. So this is resistance connected in the series. The next topic which we have is internal resistance. What do you mean by internal resistance? So you know cell, right? Battery, a small battery. So what does this cell contain? So cell contains electrodes, right? Cell contains electrodes, it contains electrolyte, and because of the chemical reaction, electricity flows. Now, when the if I draw it in detail, there are two electrodes, one is cathode and another one is anode, negative and positive terminal, and there is an electrolyte inside. Now, here in this cell, when the electricity flows, let's say you connect positive and negative terminal to some bulb. So as electricity starts flowing, electrons will also flow this electrolyte, right? For an electrons to make a complete round, actually electrons flow from negative to the positive electronic current. So electrons to make a complete round, they also have to pass through the electrolyte. As they pass through the electrolyte, they face some resistance because of electrolyte also. And the resistance which exists within the cell, it is called as an internal resistance. So what are the factors which affect the internal resistance? So factors, you can write down the definition of internal resistance as resistance due to cell. So, and what all factors add up to this resistance, those we call it as factors affecting internal resistance. Internal resistance, right, we denoted by the small r, and this internal resistance r, it is directly proportional to the area of electrodes. Obviously it is, right, if the area of the electrodes, if the area is large enough, right, electrons can easily absorb or can be donated. But if the area is very, very small, there will be less surface area available for the electrons to be donated or accepted. So greater the area of the electrodes, lesser will be the resistance. Area of electrodes. Greater the area of electrodes, lesser will be the resistance. Similarly, distance between the electrodes. So greater the distance between the electrodes, greater will be the resistance. Distance between electrode. Now if you find out the distance between the electrodes, right? Greater the distance, greater will be the resistance, because then electrons have to flow a large part through the electrolyte. So greater the distance, greater will be the resistance. And the internal resistance, it also depends on nature of electrolyte. Nature of electrolyte means electrolytes like silver nitrate, sodium nitrate, sulfuric acid, all such electrolytes will offer less resistance for the electrons to flow. And there are some other electrolytes like organic solvents, like you can say methanol, right, such solvents, they give large resistance. So these are the 1, 2 and 3 factors which affect the internal resistance. Then the next topic which we have is potential difference. Potential difference. What do we mean by potential difference? Already potential difference we have studied in the previous chapter, that it is a work done in carrying the electron from one point to the other point in an electric field. However, that is correct. Here also we have some concept or some explanation to the potential difference. Let me draw one simple circuit diagram. So if I draw one simple circuit diagram which has a cell, right, it has a switch connected to the some resistor R, external resistor R. Now I measure the potential across the cell. I want to measure potential difference across the cell. Let E be the EMF of the cell. This cell has an internal resistance, so I will denote that internal resistance here in its path by the small r, or you can just add into the circuit this internal resistance. As soon as the switch is closed, right, what happens? Current starts to flow in the circuit, right? As current starts to flow, if we apply Ohm's law to circuit, we get equation that V is equals to I R plus R. This is the equation we get. Ultimately, the current in the circuit will be E upon R plus R, correct? Now, if we apply Ohm's law, right, we just apply Ohm's law to cell. On applying Ohm's law to the cell, what will I get? Cell has an internal resistance R. So, for let's potential difference dropped across cell will be current into resistance, right? Because this is the resistance inside the EMF. So there will be some potential drop. So now the potential difference to, we apply Ohm's law to external resistance. Where is the external resistance? This capital R. External resistance R. When we apply Ohm's law here, what do we get? The potential dropped across the external resistance, let us denote by V. So V is equals to I into R. Substitute the value of I, right? If we substitute here, if we modify this equation, this first equation, if we modify now, E is equals to IR plus IR, right? So you can write down here, this is the potential difference across the external resistance, E minus IR. So this is what is to be observed, and this we, it is called as a terminal potential difference. What do we mean by this? This means, just notice, cell had EMF E, but what is supplied to the external resistance? EMF minus the internal resistance, potential drop due to the internal resistance. And the overall voltage which is delivered, right, to the external resistance, the voltage delivered to the external resistance, that we call it as a terminal potential difference. Now here if we substitute that current equal to zero, then what do we get? EMF equal to V. What does it mean? It means that EMF is potential difference when cell is not in use, right? When the cell is not in use, right, here let's say when the switch is open condition, so under this open condition, current is zero. So whatever EMF is there, the same voltage will appear here. But when you close the switch, as soon as you close the switch, you will see that the potential here will be lesser than what it appeared before the closing of the switch. So that is the difference between potential difference, terminal potential difference, and EMF. EMF is potential of the cell when cell is not in the use, and terminal potential difference is the potential difference of the cell when it is in use. We can also derive equation for the internal resistance. Let us see internal resistance, what it will be. If we modify this equation for the internal resistance, right, E is equals to I into R plus R, correct? So here internal V is equals to this equation, V is equals to E minus IR. Now if we substitute the value of I, what it will be? That will be E upon R plus R. Or you can just simplify this equation, IR will be equal to E minus V, right? So R will be E minus V by I. You can substitute, you can find out the internal resistance with this equation. Or if you substitute of I, it will be E minus V upon, value of I is E upon R plus R, right? You can simplify this equation again, ER. This will be, this equation will be independent of I. So ER, right, this thing if you simplify, it will be ER plus ER minus VR minus VR. So if we take the small, this ER, ER gets cancelled, right? If we shift this VR this side, so VR plus VR is equals to ER here just we want VR. Again we shifted this side, so ER minus VR E minus V into R upon this V if we shift this side. So this is the another equation for the internal resistance. So either you can calculate internal resistance this way. If E, V and V are given, you can calculate internal resistance this way. If E, V and I are given to you. If capital R is unknown, use this formula. If capital R is known, use this formula. So that is the formula for internal resistance. Right? Then discussion of the potential difference.
Thank you.